Good morning, everyone. It is so good to see you all on this beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning. My name's Helen Wright, and I'm part of your ministerial team, and we are so happy, so blessed that everyone can be here and join together for this service. So welcome to Unity of Las Cruces virtual Sunday service celebration, where God is good all the time, and all are welcome, safe, and loved. It's my honor and pleasure to invite Reverend Jennifer for our spiritual reading for today.
Good day. Thank you, Reverend Helen. The spiritual reading today is from How to Let God Help You by Myrtle Fillmore, Chapter 19, Spiritual Control. Our religious life heretofore has led us to feel that our thoughts and our emotions were all that were necessary to our spiritual experience. The body of man was disregarded, considered as of little consequence, and thought to be unresponsive to the finer things of spirit. A thing is not less spiritual because it has taken form, weight, and color. That which might be termed material is a misconception, an unwise combination of thoughts and elements that produces an undesirable result. Spirit becomes manifest in man's expression of what God gives. Unity emphasizes the need for control of the physical by the spiritual. But many of the things that we do and expect to control are not at all spiritual in the sense that they are in accord with God's laws and plans. The real control is in living according to the perfect pattern and law. It is not spiritual thought that prompts one to abuse the body in any way. It is not spiritual thought or desire that allows one to eat when there is no need for food, or to partake of elements of food which are not what the body requires at the time. It is not spiritual thought that causes one to worry, to become tense, or to drive the body in the effort to gain intellectually. Evidently, the individual soul has felt the need of such an earth home as the body temple. We are taking it to that body, free from the inharmonies and weaknesses imposed upon it through errors. Just now, we are convinced that the regular appropriation of certain manifest life elements is required to maintain the body at any given rate of vibration, which we know is health, endurance, and ability to transmit thought into action. We do not know how long such a plan will be in effect, and we are not greatly concerned about the matter. But it is reasonable to suppose that we shall not learn a great deal about higher laws and manifestations until we have learned to live by these present laws. When we can sustain the body in health, activity, and radiance indefinitely, we shall have gained a better understanding of the true purpose of life, and shall be ready to enter upon a mode of living that may free us from the observance of laws we term physical. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Jennifer, for those very inspiring and uplifting words from Myrtle. And today's speaker is Reverend Jennifer Kleitz, and the title of her talk is Spiritual Health. So looking forward to hearing more about that in a little while. And then Reverend Jennifer will be leading us in meditation. Our musicians today are Barry Shaw and Max Contreras, and the song is The Healing Light of Love. So also looking forward to hearing that beautiful music. And we do not have a specific item of good news today, so here is another opportunity to be on the lookout for some good news for next week, and then send the favorite good news story to share next Sunday, and sending that in to unitylascruces@gmail.com and subject line good news, attention, Ken Warner. But I do need to comment that we did have some good news, even though I couldn't understand a couple of mornings ago what on earth this sound of pouring water was. What is this? This was a very unusual way for my morning to start. So we had rain and then we had snow, for which it's definitely good news living here in the desert. So now let's just take a moment to give thanks, entering into that energy of gratitude, that we, all of us, Unity of Las Cruces, are grateful for all who enliven our church, including those behind the scenes and those who attend and watch via YouTube, those who come live to this Zoom. And in this gratitude, we do give thanks to our prayer chaplaincy and Kay Brilliant. We give thanks for the New Thought prayer team that meets every week to hold that consciousness of prayer. Give thanks for the Unity of Las Cruces board, which is now a new board, newly formed, with new energy for moving forward. We give thanks for our social media outreach with Jane Ray and everyone who helps and donates, everyone who prays, often anonymously and behind the scenes. We give thanks for our musicians, we give thanks for our speakers, including today, Reverend Jennifer. And we give thanks for all of the technology, the Zoom, the YouTube, the email, and all that work that goes on behind the scenes. Thank you, Ken. And also we give thanks for the ministry team that comes together for that spiritual purpose of the vision and the ongoing of Unity of Las Cruces. So thank you all for raising the vibrations of this universe through your prayers, your affirmations, your visualizations, and for allowing the love, the light, and the healing energy to flow in through and through all of you, all of us, out into the world. And so now we will move into our opening prayer, and I invite Kay Brilliant to lead us in our opening prayer. Thank you, Kay.
Good morning. Please join me in prayer. Mother, Father, God, we join together this morning in gratitude and joy. We affirm your presence in and through our lives. We understand the essence of your presence in us. We send peace and order to our own lives, to the lives of those in our immediate orbit, and to around the world. And we affirm, be still and know that I am God, that whatever we see with our physical eyes, whatever the discomfort, that God is there. And as we go through our meditation and prayers this week, let us hold that affirmation in a special spot. Be still and know that I am God, that God is here, God is there, and God is everywhere. Wherever we are, God is. And all the people said, Amen.
Amen, and thank you, Kay. And now we have Dave Ady with our daily word for today.
Good morning, Unity friends. Our daily word for this Sunday, March 13th, is light. Our affirmation, the light of truth dissolves all darkness. A bird's cheerful song interrupts the quiet of the night. The dark sky grows lighter and puffy clouds begin to glow with a beautiful shade of pink. Brilliant rays announce the sun's arrival. The sun peaks over the horizon, flooding the new day with light. light dissolves darkness in my consciousness in a similar way. At a challenging time, my heart responds to the hopeful thought that this too shall pass. Hope grows into faith as my mind opens to divine wisdom that is always mine to claim. Guided by the dawning light of truth, I see the way forward and follow it with confidence. As surely as each new day begins a sunrise, my faith assures me the light of truth will dissolve the darkness of any obstacle I may face. And from Scripture, John 1, verse 5, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. Will you repeat the affirmation with me, please? The light of truth dissolves all darkness. And so it is. Amen.
So it is, and thank you, Dave. And next we have our affirmation for unity with Jane Ray.
The affirmation for unity. Guided by infinite love and wisdom, and with God as our source, we now behold unlimited possibilities as unity of Las Cruces grows and prospers.
Thank you, Jane. So this is the time of the service where I have the pleasure of introducing our speaker, ministry team member, Reverend Jennifer Kleitz. And as you know, that Reverend Jennifer is a spiritualist minister from the United Fellowship Chapel Seminary and was ordained in November 2021. Reverend Jennifer has lived in Las Cruces, New Mexico since 1976. And I'd like to share that she really is a blessing. Her vision, her inspiration, her enthusiasm are incredible gifts that she brings here to share with us, and sharing her ideas, her thoughts, her inspiration. So without me talking too much, let's welcome Reverend Jennifer and look forward to hearing your message. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Helen. Good day, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here as always. The talk today is spiritual health. The theme being healing and health and being well this month. And this is a time that has been friends and family and acquaintances who have had, are encountering healing issues now are coming to me. I find myself offering prayer and assisting with counseling to help them with these issues. And one of the things that I have recognized most importantly is that physical health moves forward and gets better as our spiritual health is improved. And our spiritual health is something that comes from our spiritual practice. What I found two quotes as a Googling, everybody Googles. I don't know if that's the minister's new book of inspiration from Googling. And they were anonymous quotes, but the two of them work together very beautifully for this talk. Spiritual health is the path to inner peace, regardless of the turmoil around you. Spiritual health is what is achieved when you feel at peace with life. Now, the first one, Spiritual health is the path to inner peace, regardless of the turmoil around you. That struck me as everything is in divine right order, no matter the appearance. That's what we learn as practitioners of metaphysical principles. As new thought, unity, we recognize that within us, we have the power to create our life as we want it to be. It is our power because God is expressing through us. And as Myrtle said, Reverend Helen gave last week, I am a child of God, and therefore I do not inherit sickness. This is so important for us to recognize that we have that power within us. It is not in the hands of the doctors. It is us cooperating with our higher power. And again, it comes to that practice. Spiritual health grows stronger with practice, our spiritual practice. I found a good analogy for this the other day when I was thinking about it and recognized that, take for instance, martial arts, taekwondo, karate. People go to those classes for exercise and to learn self-defense, and they practice and they practice and they practice. And most especially those instructors who are now master instructors and grandmaster instructors, they have been learning these techniques for years, 10, 20, 25, 30 years, 50 years. Now, that doesn't mean they are being attacked on the street every day or every week or every month, or that in one of their friends is, or anything like that. They practice so that when the time comes, they are ready. And when that time comes, they are ready. They just know what to do because they have practiced so much. That is the same as our spiritual practice for our spiritual health. In our spiritual practice, we sit down, we do our meditation, we spend time in the quiet, we listen, and we contemplate, and we receive inspiration. But most importantly, we know we are connected with Mother, Father, God, always. And that supports our knowing that everything is in divine right order, no matter what it looks like. So when something comes up, we have that behind us to support us. This past week, I had an opportunity to put this into practice. I have, for the past couple of years, for whatever reason, my husband and I have not had health insurance, but now that's changed and we do have health insurance, and we're both taking the opportunity to find a primary care physician, and I went and saw mine on Monday. And it was the first time I had seen her, and I went in to do the pre-stuff before seeing her, and they took my temperature and my blood pressure. And the nurse said, well, do you have high blood pressure? And I said, no. And she said, okay. And then she took my blood pressure again. And she said, you've not been diagnosed with high blood pressure. I said, no. She said, well, it is kind of high. And I was like, well, I'm not really sure what that means. And I went to the doctor. And when I saw the doctor, she said my blood pressure was, I think she said 170 over 102. And apparently that's a high blood pressure. And so since I hadn't been diagnosed, she's having me take my blood pressure every day for the next 2 weeks, and then I'll follow up with her. and I'm not going to go too far into this story. However, what I want to point out is when I got out of the doctor's office, I did not go into this, oh my God, what am I going to do? I'm going to have to be on all these medications and I won't be able to eat this stuff and I won't be able to do that. And I didn't go there. When I stayed in my truth that I am a child of God and therefore I do not inherit sickness, I stayed in that knowing that of what I have been telling myself for years, that I do not have these conditions that may be inherent for someone of my size. I can seeing myself not from the outside, but from the inside. And so as I went through this experience, for the past week, I've been doing what she told me to do, and I've been doing a little exercise, and my husband has helped. He said, well, you're supposed to do 40 minutes of exercise, 22 once a day, or twice, 20 minutes a day. You can do Tai Chi twice a day. He said that's very good for your breathing. It's very good for calming you, and that should, you know, help. So I've been doing that. And he also thinks this is a wonderful opportunity for me to experiment on if I take my blood pressure, I do my meditation, and then take my blood pressure again and see if there's a change. And he said, if there's not a change, then you have to work on your meditation practice. So I have been taking my, measuring my blood pressure every day, and it has gone down to 132 over, what was it this morning? 132 over 78. And I'm not on medication, and I am recognizing that there are changes that are to be made. And that is the other thing. I could have looked at this as, oh, my body is letting me down. You know, what am I doing? I'm doing all this, the right stuff. I'm doing my prayer work. I'm doing my meditation. What is happening? Why is this happening? Or I can look at this and say, well, this is just a flag from Mother, Father, God that I am continuing to disregard the inspiration I'm getting to be in better health so that I can live longer, so that I can have a better spiritual experience, a better life experience. Because I am now in a place where I am so grateful for this opportunity to be able to serve as a minister and a prayerful, a prayer partner, teacher, and do these things that I want to reset. And so spiritual health works for this. You practice so that you're ready. So when these things come up, because again, regardless of the turmoil around you, things are going to come up. We've just spent the last 2 years, the entire world, and it has been devastating, but it's an experience. And depending on if you practice your spiritual health, when these things come up, you can handle them. You know exactly what to do right then, right there. And you can lift yourself up and move forward and get through it. Because you know that you are the I am. So are you struggling with spiritual health? Ask yourself, What makes me feel complete? When do I feel most connected to the rest of the world? Where do I find my inner strength? What am I doing when I feel whole? Bring these questions into your meditation and contemplation. And again, as you have this practice and your spiritual health is growing and getting stronger, you will find that you will attract others who need your help. Someone came to me a couple of weeks ago and asked for prayer for a condition. And when they came to me, they said, I have this. And I did the prayer work for them. And I talked to them afterward and I said, do you recognize the words that you used? Your thoughts, words, and actions are so powerful. When you came to me, you said, I have this. You're claiming that that's what you have. And the universe and Mother, Father, God are going to support you in that. If that's not what you want, change the words you're using. Through our thoughts, words, and actions. Through our meditation and our spiritual practice, it is so important to prepare us for when these turmoils come up. And that increases and empowers and grows and strengthens our spiritual health. Remember who you are. Practice and grow your spiritual health. Thank you. And now we'll have our meditation. Go ahead. And we'll begin by getting in a comfortable position. As you're breathing in and out, you can begin, close your eyes if that is what you choose. Whatever makes you most comfortable. As you're breathing in and out, you begin to allow relaxation and comfort to flow through you. Starting from your eyelids, allowing relaxation to flow up over your forehead. This relaxation can flow up over the top of the head, spreading through all of your scalp and down the back of your head, flowing down, down into the muscles at the back of your neck. All those muscles there, just beginning to relax in your own way. And as you allow comfort and relaxation to flow through and down, now, down from your eyelids, down through your face. Relaxation trickling down like rain on a window pane. Relaxation flowing down, down your cheeks, your jaw, so you aren't clenching your teeth together. And into the muscles at the front of your neck. All of the muscles in your head, your face, and neck just beginning to relax. You allow the feeling of relaxation and comfort to spread and flow out across your shoulders and down, down into your arms, flowing its path in your mind's eye, flowing all the way down, down through all the muscles at the top of your arms, across your elbows, down through the lower arms, into your hands, into your fingers, right to the tips of your fingers. All of the muscles in your arms beginning to relax, beginning to let go of any tension. That relaxation and feeling of comfort flowing all the way down. All the muscles begin to feel more loose, more comfortable. You allow that relaxed feeling and comfort to flow down through your body, down from the back of your neck, through all the muscles in your back. Flowing all the way down like a stream. Through these muscles on either side of the spine, this relaxation flowing down all the way to the base of the back, and all the muscles begin to relax. And your body sinks a little more into the comfort. Down through the muscles. Down through all the muscles around the waist, your abdomen. The muscles beginning to relax and feel more comfortable. And you can gradually become aware of the deeper state of comfort. Allowing that relaxation to flow down your legs, flowing all the way down over your thighs, through the muscles at the front and the back and the sides of your thighs, flowing all the way through, all of those muscles gradually beginning to feel looser, more relaxed. Over your knees, into your calf muscles, flowing all the way down into your feet, right to the ends of your toes, so that even the tiniest muscles are beginning to relax, letting go of any tension. And your feet can feel as though you have been wearing a pair of tight shoes that you've just taken off, and your feet can spread out a little as you just rest, relaxing more and more with each breath you take. All of the muscles letting go of any tension, any remaining tension draining down, down, out and out through the soles of your feet, feeling more and more comfortable. In your mind's eye, imagine walking down a path that leads to a beautiful beach, or in the mountains, or in the desert, wherever is most beautiful for you. As you arrive, use all of your senses and notice the colors, the smells, the sounds, the objects, and the feel of the place. You may be alone, or be with strangers, friends, animals. Everything is exactly as you would like it to be. This place is just perfect for you. It is comfortable and warm and safe. You can hear the ocean waves, or smell the scents of the pine forest. Find a spot where you can rest a while, perhaps sitting or lying down. Feel the support that is there for you today at this time. Nothing can affect you. Nothing can disturb you. No matter what occurs in the outside world, you are safe and supported here. As you relax even more, begin to feel the warmth and comfort of the sun touching the skin of the body. It is just the right amount of warmth, and there may be a cool breeze. Feel the warmth of the sun and the making contact with the rest of your body. You can begin to notice the place of comfort, of warmth, of safety in the center of your body. As you begin to feel the safe and warmth begin to spread its pleasant sensations, and you can imagine this warmth spreading out from the core of your body, almost like the rays of sun, spreading out through your entire body, warm, comfortable, soothing sensations. This comfort and warmth is spreading throughout the torso, the abdomen, throughout the chest, throughout the lower, middle, and upper back, spreading up the length of the spine, up into the neck and the head, down the length of the spine to the tailbone. And you can even notice the warm, comfortable sensation spreading down the legs, all the way down into the feet, spreading up. You can even notice the warmth spreading over the shoulders and down the hands. You might even be surprised to notice your hands are getting warmer and warmer. Your hands are getting warmer, almost as if you were warming your hands by the sunlight, feeling the heat from the sun going straight to the tips of the fingers, almost like you're holding a warm cup of coffee or tea or a warm bowl of soup. You can imagine the heat entering into the tips of the fingers while this warm, healing, soothing sensation travels to the arms, to the fingers. Just allow the warmth in your hands as you say to yourself silently in your mind, "My hands are getting warmer and warmer. Easy, pleasant sensations." Just take notice to enjoy this state of relaxation that you've created for yourself, feeling your whole body at ease, feeling very, very relaxed, just here, resting. And now we begin to travel back away from this beautiful, safe, comfortable scene. You imagine yourself in your mind's eye leaving and beginning to walk to the path and leaving it, knowing that you can return to this place whenever you like. that it's always there for you to come back to. You may begin to feel yourself traveling back to a state of wakefulness. Count slowly and travel back to the state of wakefulness. Keep with you any aspect of this relaxation that was useful for you today. Becoming more alert and aware, wriggling your fingers and toes, becoming more aware, feeling more calm and centered. Your consciousness and awareness return to the room. And when you are ready, you can open your eyes. Thank you.
In every life some darkness falls. You look around, you've lost it all. When your loved ones can't be there, oh, who will you call? Just remember who you are, a miracle child of the stars. When your world has all gone wrong, come and sing this song. I am becoming stronger, I am becoming whole. I walk in beauty, in the healing light of love, in the healing, in the healing, in the healing light of love. Some things in life just can't be shared or redone and repaired. Look inside and find the song you can forgive and move on. I am becoming stronger, I am becoming whole. I walk in beauty, in the healing light of love, in the healing, in the healing. In the healing light of love. So open up your heart and mind. Let your love light shine. Let the world be your friend. You'll get back the love you send. I am becoming strong. I am becoming whole. I walk in beauty, in the healing light of love, in the healing, in the healing, in the healing light of love, in the healing.
Please join me in prayer as we affirm our prayer of faith. God is my help in every need.
God does my every hunger feed. God dwells within me, guides my way through every moment, night and day. I now am wise, I now am true, patient, kind, and loving too. All things I am, can do, and be through Christ, the truth that is in me. God is my health, I can't be sick. God is my strength, unfailing quick. God is my all, I know no fear, since God and love and truth are here. Amen.
The recipient for this week is the United Fellowship Chapel. And it's easier for us to connect with them because we know our own beloved Tanya and Ken are in Tucson. So geographically, they're in the area of the United Fellowship Chapel. So we just hold our tithe in our heart center, and we bless it with that light, that love. And we send this out to United Fellowship Chapel for the ongoing of their good work, for the teaching that is international, for the metaphysical approach, for the emphasis on prayer and healing and meditation. So for all of this good works, we just see our tithe going out to United Fellowship Chapel and into the world, blessing the world with that energy. And so it is, and thank you.
Welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. Your love blessings can be made at the Unity of Las Cruces website or on the weekly email. You can mail your gift, donation, or tithe to the P.O. Box. Your gift is given in love, goes out to the others in love, and love returns tenfold. And so it is.
We do give thanks. Many, many thanks for all of your tithes, all of your generosity, all of this consciousness of prosperity. And we gratefully accept the flow of prosperity and these gifts. Thank you. The next Sunday celebration, it will be Reverend Jennifer Kleitz will be talking about loving your body. So continuing our theme of getting healthy. And so we look for more words of inspiration next week. And this is our March Sunday speaker schedule, Reverend Jennifer, next week. And then I will be rounding out the month talking about another aspects of getting healthy. Our daily word on Wednesdays continues, and it's facilitated by myself and Reverend Jennifer. So if you haven't already checked us out, then I invite you to just pop in one of these Wednesdays at 9:30 on Zoom, and the link is here and also in our weekly email. So hope to see you then. And I'll hand this over to Reverend Jennifer for a moment to speak about the book study that begins this week.
The book study beginning this week, and it will continue after we've completed with Divine Audacity. However, this Divine Audacity, Linda Martell Whitsett on the 12 Powers, as Reverend Helen has said many times, this. Her look at the 12 powers as the 12 powers of light is a wonderful contemplation. And again, using those 12 powers to help our life experience be even more joyful and healthy and powerful. I'm looking forward to this. It will be on Zoom, and it'll also be live at the Social Hall at 575 North Main Street. And we've already had several people. Books are available at the office at CSL. You can go there from 10 to 2, Monday through Thursday. And we have books available, and they are complimentary for this first book study. So just give me a call and I'll put you down on the list. And we already have several people signed up. I'm very much looking forward to this And a lot of people are looking forward to having this book study being started up again. So please join us.
Thank you, Jennifer. And as we get more and more access, and CSL is more and more open, and we look forward to opening in-person services on Easter Sunday, then there'll be more easy access for all of our ongoing projects, of which one of them is Action Program for Animals. So they always need food. They always need treats, because my cat tells me on a regular basis how much she needs the food and the treats. And of course, the cleaning supplies, which her human servant completes. So for all of these things, and for the people who might be struggling to get food or struggling to take care of their animal, just give them a thought. And if you can spare some cat food, dog food, or any of the supplies, please drop them off at the Center for the Spiritual Living in the barrel there. Thank you. And these are also ongoing barrels that we are collecting, both the food barrel and the pads and ponds and toiletries barrels. So all donations are welcome. So thank you all. Thank you for the music, the prayers, the message today. Thank you all for being here and being in our spiritual community together. So now we will move forwards into the prayer for protection and the peace song.
Please join us as we affirm the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Amen.
On was Helen could not unmute on the new computer that I'm borrowing, but I'm back and I have my voice and I'm here, so all is good. So yes. Thank you so much, Reverend Jenny, for that beautiful message and for that beautiful, beautiful meditation. And thank everyone here for being here. It's just beautiful. So blessings and peace and that message of getting healthy on all levels of our being. Thank you so much. Namaste.
Thank you.